Hello everybody. Today I just want to share a couple of projects with you. I'm busy cleaning off my desk at the moment because I'm going to rearrange my space starting tomorrow and over the weekend. But first I have to move everything and put things away. And I was fiddling around, and I did say that I was going to cover this box with the lovely things that Irene sent me. And Irene is from Seriously Scrapping, and she has a Zibbit store as well. And it was this little blue box, and as you can see, I've just covered it in the lovely trims that Irene sent me. This beautiful one here, I've used her pearl trim along the edge of the lid and the bottom of the box also. This little braid here is my own, just to break up that blue. And then on top I've put the beautiful flower that she made for me. Thank you, Irene. And a couple of layers of this pretty little ruffled lace that was in the package also. And I think that looks really quite pretty. It will sit on top of a stack of boxes, so it will, so I can put the flower on top. And I really like how that's turned out. I haven't done the inside as yet. It's for my own personal use, so I can take my time. Maybe just put book paper inside of it. And the second thing, oops, I've got a little bit of wood chip on top of there. The second thing I did was, when I was putting things away, I came across a boot I'd shown in my tutorial for the vintage style boots, and I hadn't decorated it as yet, so I thought, well, you know, I will decorate that using some of the lovely things that Irene sent me. And so that's what I've done with this little, and this is just a two panel boot. It's not the standing kind, it's just a sachet boot, I think they're called. And I recorded the process of decorating it for those who'd like to watch it. I'm very happy with how it turned out. Now it can be sort of put on display or put away for a while because it's finished. But I did use a lot of things that Irene sent me. I used this lovely embroidery anglaise or eyelet trim here. This lace here is also one that I bought from Irene's store quite some time ago. It's a beautiful, beautiful soft lace. I've used the lovely pearl spray that Irene sent me, and I've also used some lovely rosebuds there, and I think they are the same ones that Irene sent, sells in her store. I think she has some wok flowers, which are wild orchid crafts flowers, and I've used them again here. This lace here is the other half of this ruffle trim here, and I've just tied it in a bow with this beautiful silk ribbon here. The flower on the front is from Irene's store also, and another piece of the other end of this I ruffled up and put underneath that flower. A little bit of ruffled lace around the ankle there, and then this very small little Chinese braid that I got from the thrift store quite some time ago. It's a nice little small one and very easy to use. Down the front I've used this lovely lace, this one here, and I've just cut, I've cut this part off it, as you can see, and I've put one down this side, one down the other side, and then I've put the lovely little acrylic hearts and a little bit of the pearl trim. So if you want to watch how I put that all together, I'll just put a fast motion tutorial up now, just for those that are interested. So thank you for that, Irene. It was fun playing around with those goodies that you sent me, and it was also nice to get a couple of my projects finished. Boxes, I do have a few kind of half finished ones, because they're the sort of things when I'm not sure what to make, or I'm in a bit of a slump craft wise and, you know, looking for a bit of inspiration, I will paint a box or half cover a box or something, and then put it aside and then work on it again another time and put it aside. See, there's another one here, look, and that's all it's got is a bit of braid around the top, but it's not finished. I don't think the inside's finished. Oh, yeah, well, it's got things in, but this is a wooden box, so it doesn't really need to be finished inside. But you know what I mean? If the inspiration gets me, I'll just put another bit of lace around it. I won't put anything on top of that one, obviously, because this one goes on top of that one. So, unless it's something very flat. So, they're the two projects that I'm sharing with you today, and I really hope you like them. And I will put a link to Irene's store in the description box below and to her YouTube channel. And thank you for joining me today. Take care. Bye.